Alice and her boyfriend fall asleep, cozy after making love all night. When Alice goes up to take a shower, the water fills her up warm and cozy, and suddenly, the water won't drain off. She tries to close the tap, but it explodes. The stall fills up and up with more and more water. As she frantically tries to close it, she starts drowning and banging onto the door, but to no avail. When suddenly, the door gives and she finds herself in a dark alley. It's all quiet and she starts walking, when she suddenly finds herself in a nun's dress in a room full of lunatics who start looking at her with lecherous desires. Luckily, she finds the warden and is about to walk out with him when he slams the door on her face, locking her in with the lunatics. The madmen attack and begin groping her, and then she wakes up, relieved for a second. Then the lunatic attacks her in bed again, and she fights him off and pushes him, and wakes up to find out that it was all a dream. At her graduation party, she meets up with her friends, Yavin, Greta, Mark, and Dan, and they plan a pool party. She's walking home through a garden with lovely children, when suddenly it's pitch black and she sees a nun racing ahead of her. She tries to catch up and ends up in an operating room where the nun is giving birth. The baby is horrible and deformed. It screams and runs straight at Alice. She gets out of the way and lets the baby escape. She follows the baby to an old crypt, where a serial killer named Freddy Krueger was buried. The baby, seeing that it is being followed, lets out a huge scream and the ground cracks apart. In this confusion, he covers himself in the killer's clothes and ashes. And Freddy is back. Freddy moves closer to Alice and starts touching her all over with his sharp, dirty fingers. When the nun appears and Freddy backs off and disappears, the nun tells Alice to find her at the tower and the door slams shut. Alice, terrified, runs into the nearby shop and makes a call. Dan and Alice's friends are chilling at the pool when he gets a call. It's Alice and she's terrified. Dan tells her it's all gonna be okay and goes to comfort her. It's a quiet night and Dan is driving smoothly, when suddenly a hand pops out and Krueger is in the truck. Dan's seatbelt constricts him. He can't control the steering anymore and barely misses one car and another, but is not so lucky the third time. Crashes into a truck and goes flying out of the window. He lands in the swimming pool with his clothes all tattered. He tries to enter his truck, but it's locked. Afraid for Alice's security, he jumps on his bike and speeds away. He goes faster and faster, and suddenly wires pop out of his bike, pierce his wrist, jamming it onto the accelerator. He frantically tries to control his bike as it keeps going faster, and then wires pierce his leg and begin pumping fuel into his body more and more until he turns ugly, just like Freddy. Freddy's face appears on his bike and he tells him not to dream and drive. Just then, he wakes up in his truck but crashes onto an 18-wheeler just outside Alice's cafe. Alice, seeing his body, faints. Alice wakes up in the hospital. She's visited by little boy Jacob in a hospital gown. He tells her that he feels sorry for Dan's death and came to check up on her, and disappears. Next morning, Alice asks her friend Yvain, who works in the hospital, what ward Jacob was in, because she wants to visit him. But Yvain tells him that there are no children's ward in that hospital. She tells her friends about a nun called Amanda Krueger, who worked in an asylum but one day got accidentally locked with the inmates who assaulted her. She became pregnant and her son grew up and murdered 30 children and went on to become the serial killer, Freddy Krueger. Freddy was hunted down by the children's parents and burnt alive, but he's managed to come back and is killing ever since through people's dreams. Friends think she's crazy, but say that they'll support her through whatever. And if anybody tries to hurt her, they'll have to go through them first. This, unfortunately, comes true too soon, as Greta falls asleep at a fancy party and is murdered by Krueger. Mark is upset because he loved Greta and now wants to know about Krueger, but falls asleep and gets killed. Almost. Mark now agrees with Alice, but Yvonne still thinks they're both crazy. She goes to her swimming pool and relaxes in the jacuzzi and climbs onto the diving board. When it suddenly transforms into a claw, she jumps in the pool to escape it but falls in a toxic vat. Meanwhile, Alice and Mark decide the best way to kill Krueger is to find Amanda first. Alice goes to sleep and tells Mark to stay awake and watch over him. In the tower, Alice looks for Amanda and shouts her name, but is distracted by the screams of Yvonne. She tries to find Yvonne, but gets Krueger instead. He holds up a choking Yvonne, and overcome with rage, she impales Krueger and escapes into the tower. Krueger tries to follow them, but can't because of Amanda's presence. Unfortunately for Mark, he falls asleep during his watch and never wakes up again. Alice and Yvonne decide to end things. They both go to sleep, and in the dream world, Alice calls out to Krueger and taunts him to distract him so that Yvonne can find Amanda uninterrupted. In the dream world, Alice discovers that Dan is not dead because his baby boy Jacob lives on in Alice's stomach. She's overjoyed and horrified when she sees Krueger play with her future son. It turns out Krueger has fed him the souls of his victims when he was a fetus and plans to turn him into a second Freddy Krueger. Alice tells Jacob to run and he does, but Krueger is getting closer and closer and then he suddenly disappears. Alice is confused, but then Krueger appears inside of her and tries to take over her body. She fights him, but she's losing herself to Krueger and Jacob is watching, terrified. Meanwhile, Yvonne is still at the old crypt. She tries to break in and does. She finds Amanda and sets her soul free, but Amanda, instead of helping, just disappears. Meanwhile, Krueger has almost absorbed Alice's body and she's slowly fading away when suddenly Amanda appears and tells Jacob to use the powers Krueger gave him. Jacob turns just like Krueger and distracts him and asks him if he'll be his friend and teach him to kill. Krueger stops killing Alice for a second. He's surprised. He now has a friend, and perhaps for the first time in his life, feels a twinge of affection. When suddenly, Jacob unleashes the souls inside of him and they rip apart Krueger's chest and drag him towards Amanda as he screams in agony. Amanda pulls Krueger and absorbs him into herself, as Alice absorbs the now baby Jacob into herself. Alice warms up to Amanda and tries to go hug her. When suddenly Krueger's hand rips out of Amanda's belly, Alice tries to help, but Amanda basically tells Alice to off as her presence is making Krueger stronger. Alice runs away, leaving Krueger trapped with Amanda forever. A year later, Yvonne, Alice and her father are in the same park where it all began. But this time, they have a lovely child of their own.